for a foot or an inch. Yeah, I fight for you always. The truth and I'm in. Yeah, I fight for every breath that I take. And I fight for every step that I make. When you add up the inches, life or death, winning or losing is the difference. You are the witness. Inches around us, every second decisions. Too slow and I missed it, fast and I skipped it. But I'm on time, so I gripped it. If you are ready to die, then you will get this. If you're afraid of your life, then you fight for that inch. No matter how far I come, I know I still got a step to take. Rip, pull, that's it. Yeah, I do what I have to get where I got to. Eat, does that set. I've been called worse by better, so what can you do to me?
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome you to Clearfield, Pennsylvania for Combat in Clearfield 5, presented by the International Wrestling Cartel. I am Joe Dabrowski.
I am 8 Fail. How's it doing, babe?
Super Indie Championship. Enters the first butt challenger. He weighs in at 195 pounds and he's going to run the streets at night. Clearfield, while you're sleeping, ladies and gentlemen, the Neon Ninja, the Aerosol Assassin,
I am joined here for the beginning of this broadcast by a very exuberant and excited Aiden Vale, recovering from shoulder surgery on the shelf for a little bit, but still wanted to make his presence known here at our annual Clearfield stop. Aiden Vale, how you doing?
I'm doing, man. Gotta stay relevant, keeping it alive, hanging and banging, long hair extraordinaire. Jazz, the Ayatollah, Jack and Cole, whatever you want to say. Here to go.
And an athlete that you know very well on his way to the ring, the Neon Ninja, the Aerosol Assassin, Facade, here tonight, November 9th, 2013. Our first time in Clearfield in a year's time. Facade, a big opportunity and a building that has been kind to him in the past.
He's done very well here. I'm glad to see him doing big things. I spent a lot of time with him. He's a good friend of mine, teaching me a thing or two. I'll teach him a thing or two. He won't admit it, but I do.
Facade, a three-time Super Indie Champion here in the International Wrestling Cartel, lost that championship a number of weeks ago, I believe it was 3 weeks ago at this point now, to Shima Zion / Zima Ion, by any name, a very dangerous threat to any championship whenever he's around. We had originally thought that Zima would be in San Diego, California, as part of TNA's Bound for Glory pay-per-view, but Zima made a special appearance to send a message to RJ City and also to insert himself into the Super Indie Championship picture.
Did you say San Diego?
Yes.
Like, where in the world is Carmen San Diego?
That may have been where she was hiding, but not really sure.
Huh.
You got women in every town. You don't need to know that.
You know, a good friend of mine, Ludacris, had a song about that. But be that as it may, here it comes.
He weighs in at 108 pounds, wrestling out of the Philippines. He is a former TNA Exclusion Champion and your current reigning and defending IWC Super Indie Champion, Zima!
Zima, the man whose career was in jeopardy this past summer. Emergency appendicitis, tumor found in the man's colon. What a comeback it has been for the favorite Filipino of IWC wrestling fans.
You know, ever since I've seen this guy, since I was 14 years old, he's done nothing but impress me. He's definitely been someone I have looked up to very, very much. And I'm very, very, very glad to say that he and I have become somewhat of friends. We swap hairspray recipes here and again.
The eclectic entrance of the man who's not just effing pretty, but pretty effing dangerous. And the reigning Super Indie Champion for the second time. A man who really went into his own with that Super Indie Championship win back in, I believe, 2009. Former IWC Champion as well, Tag Champion, only Triple Crown Champion in this company's 12-year history.
It's quite a resume.
Indeed it is.
And he has wings.
He does.
You think he had a Red Bull before this match?
He must have.
Huh.
Not even discounting the TNA X Division Championship he held for a number of months. But Asad has really made the Super Indie Championship his own over the past number of years.
Asad knows what he's doing. I'll give him that. You know, I heard Genesis choose the color green. Have you heard that before?
I have not.
Why? Obviously, you're not a genius.
Well, not a lot of green at this table all the way around, but be that as it may. A lot of green in the pocket for whoever comes out of this matchup as the Super Indy champion. We've seen Facade survive ladder warfare. We've seen him survive the Super Indy tournament. We've seen him survive three-way dances to regain or gain for the first time that championship. Consequently, we've seen Facade literally hanging from the rafters here in Clearfield. We've seen these men go to we've seen Facade go to tournament draws with Logan Schulo. And you talk about you knowing both these men well, young Aiden. Certainly, these men know each other even better.
Absolutely, I feel like they can tell each other's moves before they even. There it goes from the Planet Hairspray, Zima.
At the risk of the ozone layer, Zima has to look absolutely perfect.
Hey, no CFCs, none of that.
Now, who do you give an advantage to here? We have pretty equal size, equal weight, equal styles, really. Both these men have studied various forms of the craft from all over the world.
To be completely honest, I'm truly undecided as to who will come out victoriously this evening. I feel very elegant to speak on this microphone. I'll tell you that, Joe Dombrowski.
Well,
these guys, like we were saying, know each other very well. They can tell each other's move before the other one can even think of it. And I'm honestly undecided. Like I say, I'm ready for the ride, babe. I'll tell you that.
I think you have to give Zima the advantage on the ground. But certainly, when it comes to an air game, Facade may be unmatched, not just here in IWC, but perhaps even in general.
I could give you that. I agree.
But you can't in any way discount the fundamentals that Facade has.
Hey, it looks like Facade had him right there.
And much to the dismay of Zima.
He messed up his hairdo.
Oh, can't have that.
Take it from me, you can't.
Looks like we have old school Zima as opposed to current day Zima based on this similar Zima as wore the Super D Championship.
Looks like a battle of the hairs, here we go.
That's a unique look.
You're right.
Zima does not seem impressed.
He's got him.
Zima also survived the high wire act known as Ultimate X to win his X Division title before losing to Rob Van Dam at Bound for Glory 2012. And these fans just all around appreciating and respecting what they're seeing between two of the finest masters of this craft you can find.
This is guaranteed to be one of the best matches of the night. And it's a shame I'm not in. I'm just kidding.
We have a huge card here.
It would be a great experience to be in with these two guys.
We have John McChesney to take on Justin Idol. IWC Championship situation. We'll talk more about that. Unbreakable Mike Elgin here from Ring of Honor. Certainly Bobby Fish from Team Big League joining us as well. You have a big eight-man tag and so much more throughout the next couple of hours. And Facade mocking Zima.
Interesting.
A little bit of hairspray versus spray paint.
Where's the garbage?
Know quite a bit about Mr. Ion's personal life.
Be that as it may, Joe.
Segways, man. Gotta appreciate that.
Segway to nowhere.
Side headlock by Facade. Wide stand, a handful of hair. Insult and injury in that respect.
That's not a good place to be, I'll tell you from experience.
Well, you control the head, you control the body.
This is true.
Facade drops to a knee that takes away the leverage that Zima has. And what about Facade, his own arduous path in recent months? Keep in mind the problems that was given to him for a number of months.
He clearly didn't listen, Joe.
Not in the least.
Joe, did you see him clearly not listening?
That never works, you know that?
You know, you're right.
What about the arduous road at Facade overcoming Ashton Amherst in recent months, including defeating him in an unsanctioned matchup? And wait a second.
No, that just ain't right. That's not right.
Zima regretting that immediately.
Immediately. There it is. Facade too smart, though.
Well, Zima's trying to run away, but he's...
It's obviously not working.
He's only got about 18 feet to work with.
What's this, Facade? Uh-oh.
What are you doing? Give my hairspray. Give my hairspray. What are you doing?
He knows what he's doing.
Well, Facade styling and profiling a little bit. Not much you could do with Facade's makeup there, but you know, try as you might.
He's got a good thing going.
It works for him.
Oh, but not for Zema Iron.
Not in the least. And Zema getting so possessive, so territorial, based on that Super Indie Championship reign, really changed him.
This is really not like him.
And you gotta believe part of that anger is because, once again, I don't sense this being a coincidence. This is a pattern. Who is not here, Aiden Vale, but RJ City?
Oh, man. You hear that outside. You're absolutely right, Joe.
RJ City formed his alliance with Justin LaBar. Oh, man. Zema hits hard. And that could be a game changer. You can hear, you can hear the thud. You can feel the reverberations throughout this entire building.
I think the whole crowd felt that. I know I did.
Well, just imagine how Zema felt.
For real, for real. Don't believe Kazan could win this championship by countout, is that right?
That is completely accurate. Pinfall or submission only here in the International Wrestling Cartel. Zema tried to sneak in from behind.
Facade said, no way, babe.
No more games. Give me the hairspray.
Yes, more games.
Give me the hairspray. No. Yes. No. Yes. 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 Well. Yes.
Since he asked so nicely.
Oh, man.
That didn't work out well.
Come on, Zema.
Man, Zema off his game, but you gotta blame RJ City on that. RJ forged his alliance with Justin LaBar a number of months ago on Chair Shot Reality when RJ kicked Zema straight in the midsection that had just had surgery. Zema's still recovering from surgery at that time as Facade hits a nice heel kick. Very tender area of the body.
Absolutely.
Zema went down in a crumpled heap.
I can relate. I mean, absolutely. 100% to that, I can relate to that. If someone hit me on my shoulder right now, it wouldn't be good. So I can understand exactly what Zima's going through.
And now a double handful of hair.
That's just had more. Insult.
Zema's got so many problems right now. And that ringing in his head can be added to the list.
Just can't get off the floor.
Facade.
Gonna go big.
Yeah, looking to get that momentum.
Here it is.
Got a double spring.
Oh, buddy's too smart.
Again, a step ahead, knowing your opponent.
Oh.
Facade punting Zema right to the sternum, but nobody home.
Facade's no stranger than that barber. I know he's feeling that.
Zema out of the way. Facade crashes. What looked to be maybe neck and jaw first into that guardrail, and Zema beginning to take over. Well, Zema going high risk, hasn't worked well thus far.
Pretty effing dangerous up on the top rope.
To be sure, to himself and others.
Oh.
Nicely done with a clothesline.
Come on, Facade, get up, bud.
Now, Aiden, are you learning anything about these athletes, seeing as how it's very possible you'll be in the ring one day with these guys?
I'm studying them, absolutely. Every single match that they're in, I'm studying tapes, man. I'm doing all that I can to stay on top of the game.
Just like the old days.
Just like the old days.
You used to be sitting next to somebody else, though, didn't you?
And who was that?
I don't know.
I wish I knew where that kid was right now.
Who'd he ever beat? Hairwringer by Zema Ion. Don't see that every day, but again, this has turned into a battle of pride over their follicles. Neckbreaker, nicely executed, only a count of one. There's the instincts of a champion. Don't stay on your shoulders any longer than you need to.
Absolutely.
You can see the torque put on the shoulder, put on the neck.
Just look at the grimace in Facade's face.
And you can see the angle of Facade's lower back, that lumbar region.
I tell you what, he's very flexible, but I'm sure that's not helping any bit at all in this situation.
Well, he's flexible when he wants to be, but certainly when you got somebody bending your body for you, it's another story. But Facade does spend just countless hours, those neck bridges, those stretching exercises.
You know what, man? It's not, I can't even do it.
Helps.
He's mad at me because I can't do it. Here it is.
Helps him be so nimble, got two. Well, Zema wants to get the heck out of Clearfield. That's quite obvious.
It's a great place. I don't understand.
Oh, you gotta love Clearfield.
It's a field and it's clear. What's not to love?
Well, there you go. I see you've seen a lot of the scenery, haven't you? But great place, great people. Salt of the earth, working class.
The school over here, it has its own half pipe, which is for skateboards, rollerblades, bicycles. Scooters. I was a mean machine on a scooter when I was in fourth grade, Joe. I'll tell you what. You see a razor, it was over.
Zeman looking to make sure this matchup's over. Wearing away on Fassad, keeping the tempo slow. Fassad out of his comfort zone.
Hey, he's up on that top rope. I wouldn't be too sure that's his uncomfort zone.
Well, Zeman looking to send him out the hard way. Superplex. Fassad adjusting his weight positioning. And Zeman falls.
This could be it. This could be the match changer.
Neon Ninja with a chance. Zeman doesn't see him. Fassad walking the rope.
Yes!
Oh! Firebomb, the dropkick. It took a lot out of Fassad, but it's what he needed to do.
He needs his crowd's help. Come on.
It's what Fassad needed to do to get that respite.
This crowd obviously behind Fassad. There it goes. Come on.
Series of rights, but countered by the knee. Zeman trying to stay a step ahead, but Fassad quickening the pace. Inverted atomic drop.
That's not too pretty.
Standard style coming up. And I think the lineage of Zeman Ion Kids may be ending. The fireman's carry. Down face first, sit out style.
Come on, Fassad. One.
All impact could have him.
So
History could be made here. Fassad could become a four-time Super Indie champion.
Four times?
I believe that's tied for the record.
Wow.
Arashikage Driver could do it.
This could be the end.
Zeman again knows
it
coming.
He knows it.
Back and forth. Now Zeman catches himself that time. And Zeman catches the foot of Fassad, second time, got him!
That's the thing about Fassad, man, he's got those kicks, he's too dangerous.
You never know which direction he's coming from. And now...
Here he goes!
Gonna fly lightning fast speed.
Zeman saw it.
Yeah, up onto the apron, quick counter.
Up on the apron, click, click, click!
And now Fassad, springboard, another kick! Those side round kicks up Fassad, man. So tough to scout, so tough to prepare for. The German, beautiful bridge, Hafner.
So close, man. I thought that could have been it.
And when you get a bridge at such a really, it's still a cute angle, for lack of a better term. That just
it's
adds-
a very handsome angle.
That adds so, that's not what I meant. That adds so much pressure downward on Zima's shoulder, so much tougher to kick out.
Watch this, though.
Fassad looking to finish this thing, but Zeman rolls out. Is that the hairspray again? He's getting the hairspray and he's getting out of town.
His hairspray ain't going on.
Fassad not going to let him.
If only he were a hair away further.
And Fassad going to make him pay for it. I think.
I'll tell you what, this crowd's ready to see Zeman pay for it.
I think Zeman just wants to get out of here with his title and look forward to RJ City. Tug of war now. Official has to get that championship out of there.
Did you say what?
Come on.
Oh, come on. Come on, ref.
The hairspray to the eyes stacks him up on the shoulders and Zeman Ion.
See, that ain't right.
Here is your winner and still IBC Super Indie Champion.
That's your champ, Joe Dombrowski.
He's your champ. You talk over Pedro like he does, but be that as it may, it got personal in the early going with these two men. There may be a lot of mutual respect outside the ring, but the competitive nature of the Super Indie title took this over the top. And in the end, Zeman felt disrespected with the hair. He gave Fassad right back to him in the form of that hairspray. But question this as you might. Zeman does not deserve what has happened to him lately at the hands of RJ City.
I will give him that.
And hopefully we will see that clash in the very near future. Our thoughts with Fassad as he clears the hairspray out of his eyes. But Zeman, still your Super Indie champion. One of the biggest surprise stories of 2013. Zeman back home with gold around his waist. Coming up next, member of Team Big League, or is he, taking on an STD? Bobby Fish, Andrew Palace next. Singles action on tap. Combat in Clearfield 5. Two very diverse factions.
The steampunk enthusiast.
what do you know about STDs?
I can tell you a thing or two about a thing or two, but that's a story for another day.
Well, perhaps the most annoying, obnoxious, and consistent of the STDs is Andrew Palace.
He is a rotten one to deal with. I've had him a time or two before. Can't get rid of him.
Yeah. You think he's gone, but he keeps coming back. That's Andrew Palace in a nutshell. Maybe the most talented of the STDs.
Nutshell, really?
Also, among the most delusional.
Yeah.
Sexy, talented dudes. I won't say he's among the sexiest. That, I'll let them figure that out amongst themselves. Maybe Ginger.
Ginger? Eh, redheads, man. I don't know.
What do you do? Go for the dowel?
You know what, man? I'd like to take that dragon out for a night or two.
Bobby Fish found himself in a very unexpected situation 3 weeks ago at Retro Reunion, our previous IWC DVD release from Sorgatron Media. Bobby Fish was hand-selected by Dalton Castle as the opponent of John McChesney. It was pick each other's opponents night in lieu of Dalton Castle and John McChesney one-on-one, one final time for the IWC title this December at Winner Take All 13. And Bobby Fish nearly beat John McChesney. Listen into this. Now he's done. There you go.
John, we know what type of fish Bobby Fish is?
The round-eyed samurai variety, according to him.
Okay.
Studied and competed extensively in Pro Wrestling Noah in Japan. And, of course, won out the Ring of Honor World Tag Team Champions as part of Red Dragon, along with Kyle O'Reilly, the self-proclaimed ambassador of Kick Your Assiter.
What a name.
And Bobby Fish, not happy with the tepid response.
There he
Bobby
goes.
Fish,
what's
a
people on their feet.
What's a hero's welcome?
Palace doesn't seem to be too happy about this.
Well, Palace looks at the world through rose-colored goggles. I don't think he appreciates or understands how disliked he really is.
Oh my God. Clearfield, Pennsylvania. Good Lord, that brings a tear to my eye. Now, if I could ask you one more time to get up out of those seats. And I apologize for requesting this again. But being that I was so emotionally moved by that gesture, I would like to, if you'll let me, lead you in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Such an American.
What?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation,
under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I love Clearfield.
Madness.
Well, we're in the core futuristic time machine. It's 1983.
Hey, what a good year that was, wasn't it?
It's Sergeant Slaughter. Where are we? Hamburg, PA? I can't even remember. Oh, back into 2013, Bobby Fish. I had a lot of questions about Team Big League, but I have a new set of questions now.
I got a question or two for Team Big League.
Yeah, well.
Jimmy Nuts especially.
Well, yeah, you have a severe history with Jordan Lennox, Port of War, versus Nuts and Brooks concerning the Tag Team Championship. It was sad to see you guys not able to get an upcoming opportunity based on your injury, but
it's a shame.
I'll tell you what, though, Aiden, it was great to see Paul London come out of the woodwork to substitute for you in that tag team matchup against Team UK.
Wasn't that nice of him?
The Intrepid Traveler. Hope to see him again here in IWC.
It was a great honor to be in the same ring as Paul London. I know I wasn't working with him or anything, hey, but it was an honor to stand there and be on the same team as him.
Absolutely.
Having him in my corner.
You guys were chasing girls after the show, according to the IWC After Show.
Different area codes, Joe. Yeah. Be that as it may.
Well, Andrew's having a conniption fit right now.
He's having some fun with the kids. Aw, loser. seems like they're telling him he's looking pretty dumb.
Well, it's up to Palace to prove him wrong. He's not done much so far. You gotta wonder where the rest of the sexy, talented dudes are. I know they're preparing for a big tag match later tonight.
Did you see that, Joe? They have the finger of their thumb in the shape of an L on their forehead.
Fish with a takedown, amateur style. I don't think, I think Fish has done a great job of psychologically defeating Palace already. But I got a lot of questions for Bobby Fish because we saw some disagreements, the old token malfunction of the junction between the members of Team Big League a number of months ago at Mountain State Madness. And then when Fish was selected as McChesney's opponent, it seemed like Fish maybe wanted to prove himself against McChesney, not just hang back, maybe like McChesney would have won it.
And she's on to something there. There he goes.
And you gotta wonder, I mean, the splintering power. It seems like we're getting two different stories from John McChesney and from Norm Connors. It seems like we're getting two stories from Jimmy Nuts, what he says, and from Joseph Brook, what he does.
That's very true, man.
And how, I've been asking this for a couple of months, how does Justin LaBar factor into all of this? Because apparently LaBar's had some sort of communication with Team Big League that Norm takes personal exception to.
You think maybe we'll find out some more information tonight on that?
We may. I'm not really sure if Norm Connors is here or not. John McChesney's been very quiet, kept to himself. Jimmy Nuts is not here due to injury he suffered back at Retro Union.
Hey, I can't say I feel sorry for him.
Well, no, that's a bit of karma, wouldn't you say? Brooks has a big matchup later tonight. He'll take on Dennis Gregory. Another faction versus faction war of two factions you see normally battle.
Did you say war?
I did say war. They are not rock stars, though.
Nobody is, Joe. Nope.
Paul London was for a night. Paul London, mosh pitter extraordinaire, for the ride. Pace quick, it's Fish. Damn. High elevation, right
Damn,
on the...
That's the experience.
Right on the butt of the jaw. I think the STD's been turned into a recessive gene.
Not gonna touch that one?
I don't think you should. Might be contagious. Briggs in with the Guerrero style helo. Does Bobby Fish.
Hello.
And Palace needs some respite on the outside. One of the biggest tests to date for Palace, I would say.
You could say that.
I did say that.
You could say it again?
Quite nicely, I might add.
That's what you, okay. Never mind.
But this crowd telling the story again, feeling Palace is indeed a loser.
These kids right here, those seem to be Palace's biggest fans.
And keep in mind the weird history that Fish and Palace have. Keep in mind, in the leading up to last year's Super Indy, Fish actually hired Palace as a surrogate to qualify for Super Indy for him.
I remember that.
Palace did not get in, but Fish got in by proxy.
Palace going to work on that shoulder.
You gotta believe that. Well, that's something you know well.
All too well, unfortunately.
That must stick in the craw of Palace to this day. Well, let's talk about this, Aiden. You bring up a great point. Now, you would know better than anybody with your continuous problems. How do you counteract a shoulder injury in the course of battle?
So you gotta protect your weaknesses, Joe. You gotta fight. You gotta attack their strengths before they can attack your weaknesses. And unfortunately, that's something I haven't been able to do myself as much as I would like to. You gotta practice what you preach sometimes, and unfortunately, that doesn't always help you.
Well, I think a lot of that can be blamed back to Jimmy Nuts once again. Keep in mind, a lot of damage done
it all
to you.
Comes back to him.
As you know very well, most of the damage done to you were cheap shots taken after the matchup.
Seems like that was a reoccurring thing. It's a bone I have to pick with Chuck still.
Well. Most important thing is to get you to 100% so you can come back here. Hopefully, War can challenge Team Big League into the future, championships or not.
That's it, man. Got my eyes on the prize, man. Go for the gold.
And there's a count of two from Palace. If Palace wins this matchup, that's going to really raise the stock of the sexy, talented dudes. Not only has Palace beat Team Big League's one of his top henchmen, and a man who was main eventing Retro Reunion, but also he pins a bona fide World Tag Team champion.
That's something to add to the resume.
Absolutely
and
true.
And it looks like, by the way it's going right now, Andrew might have it.
I think Palace is certainly a diamond in the rough.
I'm
not really sure what Chess Flexer thinks about or does, and I think Corey Futuristic's probably a borderline embarrassment, but...
He's just rolling the dice, man. That's all Corey does.
That's
he
what
just
he does.
Rolls that dice.
But Andrew Palace, man, he's got skills. I don't think he realizes how talented he is. If he did, he wouldn't be in that group.
So we're saying he's the talent of the sexy talented dudes.
Yeah, I'm not sure who the sexy is, and I'm not hurry to find out the dude.
Seems like we're narrowing it down.
I wouldn't call that rat's nest on his head sexy, that's for sure. You know all about hair and conditioner and shine and bounce and all that stuff.
Hey, you gotta get that mane and tail growing along.
There you go. Is that horse shampoo?
What?
Is that horse shampoo?
Are you horse shampoo? Oh, in the corner.
Bobby Fish following through nicely here. Again, you talked about moments ago the veteran instincts.
But see, that shoulder's already bothering him.
Yeah, but he's working around it. Cover to a no.
Talk about a veteran for as inexperienced as Andrew is. It looks like he does know to stay on. He knows to stay on a target whenever he's already got it locked in.
Systematic dissection.
Oh, right in the throat.
And we saw from Basad earlier how those round kicks can affect you. Fish, a similar playbook. Again, that promising Noah background. And Fish went to go up and over Palace.
Lift himself up right now.
Yeah, couldn't do it. There's the damage done.
Sticking to it.
Oh, Palace just wrenching that arm and shoulder. Fish down straight onto that clavicle area. And again, something you can relate to.
German suplex, only in America. Come on.
Well, Palace rolls with it. Not a cover attempt. Second time. And again, this is impressive straight. You have to deadlift your opponent off the ground twice now. Execute this maneuver. That's something that a guy of Palace's size, you maybe wouldn't expect.
This kid keeps impressing you, man.
Northern Lights with a bridge for two.
I'm a kid myself, but look at this guy, man. He's just reversing after reversing. Yeah. On top of his
game. Well, now it's here we make the mistakes. Palace going for the goggles, which hasn't worked once yet. If you listen to Justin Plummer in Items the Aftershock, it's some kind of weird, like, psychedelic, like, mushroomy
sort of LSD
type Woodstock Altamont type of thing going on here.
Let's see if he can get the top rope going, though.
This has never worked.
Come on, man.
Never worked. He's going to show it to these kids.
Hey, it was the first time for everything. That's what I tell the chicks. Come on.
Will it be in Clearfield?
Oh, not today.
Nothing doing. And Bobby Fish with an opportunity.
Oh,
T-Bone! Release style.
I could go for a stake. Here it is.
Oh, near fall. Half a count away from Bobby Fish. Victorious in this matchup. But again, credit to Palace for lasting so long.
Absolutely. This is back and forth, man.
And Palace got some fight. I think Bobby Fish bringing out the best of Andrew Palace right now.
I think Bobby Fish may have underestimated him just a little bit.
Which is easy to do with those machinations of the STDs, but then again, that plays to their favor.
Joe, I'm sick of this. I'm not touching that.
That wasn't a pun. That was a good point. The sexy, talented dudes throw you off with their machinations. You forget how good Palace is.
He's the talent. We discuss this.
Oh, not up that thigh muscle.
That.
First one didn't get him. Second one on the money. I could have knocked him out. Bobby Fish, cover. Got him.
There it is.
Here's your Bobby Fish.
What an emphatic victory. What a shot right to the side of the temple. The lights go out quickly.
Can't say I'm not surprised, but I will say that for a minute there, I thought maybe we could see him the other way, but Bobby Fish is experienced, man. Bringing it home.
Bobby Fish, still a Ring of Honor World Tag Team Champion. Still a big part of Team Big League. But where's Team Big League going? It's McChesney and Castle. Norm Connors is the referee. Who can we trust? Who's working for who? Hopefully we'll find out. Winner take all 13.
He weighs in at 235 pounds, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Here is H.D. Killer.
HD, the pride and joy of the ICWA class of 2012.
Cannonball!
A man that's done just an amazing amount of things. A man that's beaten John McChesney. A man that's teamed with Michael Tarver. A man that's done so much in just a short career. Really a blue chipper. Really a just an instant success story in the International Wrestling Cartel. But what must be going through the man's mind that his mentor and trainer turned his back on all the IWC school students.
That can't be said well, man.
And his opponent.
And now, one man aligned with HD's trainer.
Representing the $2. He weighs in at 242 pounds. That's from Las Vegas, Nevada. Here is Jimmy Vegas.
When you talk about power, when you talk about experience, you talk about a track record, you're talking about Jimmy Vegas, one of the most, if not the most dominant, athlete in IWC in the first half of the 2000s.
Vegas, baby.
And Vegas hadn't lost a step. Him and Gregory, the former tag champions. Of course, Dennis Gregory, the only five-time IWC champion in history. And maybe the only man that could pull off that jacket. But a rematch for Retro Reunion, Vegas disqualified for not breaking on the five count. Vegas just smothering, just punching, choking all over HD Cannon. Vegas has a temper. We saw it 3 weeks ago.
Hey, I wouldn't want to be in the way of Vegas when he's a little mad, what'd you say? I want him on my team.
But this is the roadblock that Justin Idol has put in front of his kids, in front of his students. Keep in mind, we didn't know Idol was part of the Founding Fathers until Mountain State Madness 5, when Denny Gregory and Idol came out together to take on HD Cannon and Sam Cassidy. What a culture shock that must have been.
Is Vegas starting to show?
You expect to face the Founding Fathers, and you get one Founding Father and your mentor. Aiden, you've had a lot of mentors in your short career. How would it feel having to not compete against one in a competitive contest, but fight one?
Man, I would be heartbroken. You know what I mean? Especially if we were ever bad blood. But on good terms, that would be quite the honor, but that's just not the case here.
Not at all. And the fact that Idol won't even get in the ring with these gentlemen. Of course, Idol, a big championship matchup later on. Vegas throws HD Cannon back into the ring. This matchup not taking long at all to degenerate on the outside.
Ah, Cannon, there he goes. Ready to come back. Hammies on Cannon, man. Look at those things.
Well, certainly, both these men in excellent shape. You don't look like that waiting for the bus, as Gorilla Monsoon used to say.
That as it may.
And HD, giving Vegas a little bit of a receipt for Retro Reunion. I don't think this will be a technical classic. This is going to be a straight brawl.
Looks like we got a full house here tonight, Joe.
Oh. And there's a spine buster. HD elevating the big man. Vegas has got to go about 270 or 80. HD feel good about himself, but he's not following up.
You gotta stay on him, man.
No, don't pace around the ring and talk to people. Cover the guy.
Yeah, there he goes, though. Look at this.
Too much time. Shots to the kidneys by Vegas. You don't let a veteran like Vegas recover.
You can't give him that time. Not at all. Look at that. Because then you get kicked in the chest.
Man,
in the face. You kick everywhere.
Man, it's beating CM Punk, beating Raven, beating Sandman, beating Tommy Dreamer. Withstood a barrage of Jerry Lawler pile drivers that nobody has since Road Warrior Hawk. Clothesline. No nonsense is Jimmy Vegas.
Bam! Got a nice beard, too.
There's a cover. Not a lot of body on body on that cover. Not a lot of respect shown by Vegas, really, towards anybody.
Hey,
but especially HD Cannon.
Oh! What was that?
An HD? Did HD go downstairs?
Wouldn't do that.
The official cautioning HD Cannon. I want to give the guy the benefit of the doubt. Vegas down like a heap. Jake Clemens asserting his authority. Nicely done. I know ref in Canada are very happy watching this right now. And Vegas with a
straight to the face. But right back though. There it is. Look at this.
Hey, you can hear the
bare knuckles, man.
Hear the impact.
Oh, holy cow.
Vegas spiked himself. That was so impactful. And now.
Hey, man. Come on.
It's Retro Reunion all over again. Is he going to break? Now you put your hands on the official. Come on, Vegas.
What's Jake Clemens going to do, man? He's a pipsqueak.
We don't need this.
He's going to get disqualified.
No. Referee being lenient. We want to see a decisive winner. But HD just rolled
real
up
quick,
Vegas.
Real quick.
Vegas got trapped and got
it. That's it. That's all it takes.
HD wins.
Horatio, we'll get the hell out of that ring right now.
And Vegas gonna make HD pay for this one. Man, HD got a lucky win. Vegas, his temper threw him off his game. Did Vegas and HD capitalizes. Another big win in this man's young career, but man, HD not gonna forget about Jimmy Vegas anytime soon, that's for sure. Up next, two heavy hitters. Dalton Castle, weeks away from his final IWC title opportunity. He's got 350 plus. A Team Big League's enforcer.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, it is time for a very special in-ring edition, as voted by you, the fans, of IWC Aftershock. So ladies and gentlemen, please get on your feet and welcome Mr. Justin Plummer.
I think Plummer's renting LaBar's set. Hope he got a good deal on it.
Those two fought right now. Who do you think would win? Let's take them back out. Let's take them outside the alleyway.
I know who the losers would be.
Who's that?
All of us.
Ah.
I got my money on Plummer, though. He doesn't need to wear a leather jacket to make his arms look big.
He seems to be no stranger to the gym. Is that weird for me to say?
You know what Justin LaBar's favorite machine at the gym is?
What's that?
Vending machine.
Ah. But I'm changing.
Justin Plummer, there was a poll online at IWCWrestling.com. Fans could vote on which live show they would get to see, a live edition of IWC Aftershock, our regular web series, or a live edition of Chair Shot Reality, Justin LaBar's weekly self-serving internet show where he just puts himself over and wears fancy suits.
Nothing wrong with wearing fancy suits, man. Fancy pants is what it's all about.
Live Chair Shot Reality, the bane of my existence.
Testing. Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome to a live edition, as voted on by you, of IWC Aftershock! Now, I'm going to be very quick about this, but I wanted to take one moment to thank all of you. It was actually almost exactly 3 years ago today when I made my IWC debut. I got a call from Chuck Roberts, and Pedro was under the weather. They didn't have a ring announcer. I dropped what I was doing and I made my way out to a place called Clearfield. I got in the ring, I looked out at all these people and I was horrified, but it was only a matter of seconds before all of you made me feel so at home. I was able to perform so well that they hired me on full time and I've been living my dream ever since. So thank you all so much for being my home in professional wrestling for the rest of my life.
Hey Plummer, first rule in announcing, it's not about you. Get the hook.
And thank you all so much for going to IWCWrestling.com. I know we had a poll. I could have been spending my day at home today, but because you voted, I'm here with Aftershock and Justin LaBar is spending the night at home. And trust me, for those of you that don't know him, that's a good thing. But enough about me. Without any further ado, I'd like to introduce my guest at this time, a personal friend and one of the greatest athletes to ever set foot in an IWC ring. Ladies and gentlemen, get on your feet and help me welcome the heavy metal Jesus, Logan Shulo!
Logan Shulo is a man who's been surrounding the IWC title picture pretty much all year.
Yeah.
Dalton Castle, John McChesney, Logan Shulo, they've almost been intertwined, but when Logan had his opportunity at the championship at Friday Night Fights, boy did we see an unwelcome, unexpected surprise when the notorious Shane Taylor came out of nowhere, 350 plus, leveled Shulo, injuring him, first time we've seen Logan since. He's been injured for several weeks, great to see him back, and you can tell, he hasn't been using this off time to lay around. He's been working hard.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Logan Shulo. Logan, I got to hit you with a tough one right off the bat here, and I apologize, but it's been 2 months since we've seen you in an IWC ring, and that's because we all know back in White Oak 2 months ago, Shane Taylor made his return to the IWC, attacked you from behind during your match with Tom McChesney, and put you in the hospital for the night. Now you're back. You have Mike Elgin a little bit later on, but I gotta ask, are those rings 100%? Are you ready for that match?
Justin, everything you said was right. Shane Taylor robbed me of what means most to me here in IWC. That's a heavyweight title. I had John McChesney beat, and Shane Taylor came out, busted up my ribs, put me on a shelf. But I'm here to say I'm 100%. I've gotta take care of Michael Elgin tonight. And I'm going to throw this out there right now. Winner Takes All is coming up December 14th. And I don't have an opponent. So Shay Taylor, if you're out there listening somehow, I'm putting it out there. Me against you, December 14th. Let's settle this.
That's a huge challenge.
I'm going to you guys like Logan Solo and Shay Taylor in December. You want to see Logan versus Shay? I think the challenge is official. We'll have to get word from him later on. But we have one more piece of business before I let you go here. If you've been following us on Twitter or checking us out on Facebook, you know we had a very big announcement tonight. It was sent to after shut everybody. Well, now it's time. Logan, you have some big news tonight, and what better place to announce that news than right here on a live edition of IWC Aftershock. Yeah, take it away.
Justin, I'm so excited. I want to first off thank everybody here to witness this, okay? I've been very fortunate in the past couple weeks. I've been...
What is this?
No!
Now joined by Zima Ion, who competed earlier tonight in the Super Indie Championship matches. We thank Aiden Vale for joining us throughout the beginning of this broadcast. And no one is thanking this man for joining us.
When will we know the announcement?
I don't know. Well, I thought this music didn't fit LeVar, and that explains it. 350 pounds plus of the notorious Shay Taylor, the man that put Logan Chulo on the shelf. But again, LeVar is supposed to be at home. This is not his show, not his announcement.
He's on the wrong side of the tracks right now, Joseph. But
my name
he seems comfortable.
Is Justin LeVar. And there is nothing that you have to say or announce that is more important than what I have to say. And as for you, Justin Plummer, I am really disappointed in you. I know that you paid somebody off and fixed that IWC. There's a virus on IWC wrestling that I probably, that's why you won that poll. I am much more popular and incredible than you'll ever be.
Virus in this building.
But on to the matter of tonight, I'm not here to do interviews, I'm not here to do chair shot reality. I'm here because this man, Shay Taylor, called for me. You see, last time he was here in Clearfield, he was rudely treated with disrespect and disdain from you people.
The earthquake.
And he is smart enough to know not to come into a cesspool like Clearfield without proper representation. So, as representation, speaking on his behalf, I gotta ask, how stupid are you? This man injured your ribs, put you in the hospital, you lost a month of your career.
Logan doesn't need this. Michael Melkin later tonight.
I'm challenging you, December 14th. I'm the representation here. Talk to me. Go ahead. I'm throwing the challenge out there. What do you say? December 14th, me and the boy Shay Taylor. No, you know what? Hey, before you do, I say we get this done right now.
Whoa. We got a fight. Bedlam. And Plummer's trying to keep LeVar at bay. Chulo disposes of Taylor. And now, do it. Get your hands on him. Do it for me, Logan. Oh, come on. LeVar sneaks out of there. Taylor, no. Oh, Plummer just got it. Oh, no.
He's dead.
Get these guys out of here. Shay Taylor, a mammoth of a man. He injured Logan Chulo with that mask, and Chulo is trained for this type of punishment. Plummer is not.
I mean, he might have a broken rib or something. I teamed with Shay Taylor for many months, and I know how vicious that man is.
I've never seen him this focused, and Chulo noticeably upset. Chulo's got to worry about Michael Elgin later tonight. He's got to worry about Shay Taylor at Winner Take All 13, but...
And he's got an announcement that he still hasn't told him.
What is the announcement? And why is Justin LeVar representing Shay Taylor, who for all intents and purposes is a member of Team Big League? Does this go back to some of Norm Conner's issues with LeBar that we don't know about. I hope the plumber's okay. Taylor's injured one, and I wouldn't be surprised if that list just grew. What a tragic ending to this. We have certainly we expected a far different ending here with LeBar not even supposed to be here.
Jeff Clements, hold him back. Logan, listen to me. And you, LeBar, shut up! Nobody here wants to hear you! And you! You put this man out for 1 month and put him in the hospital. And I don't appreciate that. You know why? Because this man is IWC. And you're just begging for your last chance in this company, aren't you? I'm going to give you, Logan, you're going to get exactly what you asked for. And winner takes all. Down in Elizabeth on December the 14th, but Logan, I'm going to tell you guys, you're not going to disrupt the show. You guys put your hands on each other before that. You're done. That's the way it's going to be. We got a show to run, so you control now the guy that you're managing here tonight. And Logan, please go to the back. Now help out Palmer. Come here. Somebody.
Thank God Chuck was here to take charge in a situation that rapidly got far too out of hand. LeBar strutting around like he did something. So full of himself. And what scares me is Shane Taylor hadn't left yet. Our thoughts are with Justin Plummer.
Yeah, hashtag pray for Plummer.
We should start it. We know this was a really big night for him. He was happy about the poll, happy to be back here in the city he started his wrestling career in, and certainly did not end the way he had.
Well, he didn't, but...
Oh! And we're not done here. Here comes the party peacock, Dalton Castle! And it looks like Dalton and Taylor jump-starting their altercation. And this matchup, the bell has rung. We need a referee. And Dalton Castle is pumped. Oh, but he tried to slam 375. Got caught. Got goozled. And Castle fires back with a dropkick and just weeks away from what may be Dalton's final shot at the IWC title at John McChesney. You can see Dalton has renewed life.
And LeBar, once again, trying to interfere.
What a roadblock this is, Zima, on the road to Dalton and McChesney. We see two injuries from Taylor. Will Dalton make it to Winner Take All?
Yeah, he's definitely not got it easy tonight.
LeBar's going to run all the way to Winner Take All right now.
Oh, can't really see here, but it appears that Shane Taylor has done something to take out Dalton Castle in the aisleway.
My God, Taylor. And when you run into Shane Taylor, it feels like Shane Taylor runs into you.
Exactly. I can speak from experience. Like I said, I teamed with the guy for months. This is not somebody that I would never want to be in the ring with him personally.
But as successful as you were with Shane Taylor at your side, I don't think anything compares to the version of Shane Taylor we see as associated with Team Big League, with John McChesney at the helm, with Norm Conner's evil mind helping guide him.
Yeah, it's definitely scary. This is the most focused I've ever seen with Earthquake. And it's a guy that's hungry. He wants his job back. He wants a top spot, and he's clearly showing he'll do whatever it takes to get it.
Absolutely. But what do you make of the miscommunication lately? It seems we've heard two different things from the head of Team Big League, from John McChesney and Norm Conner. Is there a rift at the top, or is there some kind of grand plan we're falling into?
I don't know. It seems like there's two different cooks in the kitchen here, Norm Conner, John McChesney. I'm not sure which one seems to be the one with the most power, but definitely there's some dissension in the ranks there for control of Team Big League.
And why is Justin LeBar representing a member of Team Big League and Shane Taylor, if Shane Taylor's an official member?
What is he doing? I thought he was representing RJ City. This guy's all over the place.
Norm Conner is the executive consultant of Team Big League.
Yeah. And certainly, this is definitely a confusing story.
Certainly you can speak quite well, Zima, about how annoying Justin LeBar can be. And it was very apparent in your matchup with Facade the frustration that's been mounting just in your mind over RGC the past couple of months. Certainly some flashback to the old school Zuma just based on how, what kind of a mood you've been in.
I think Clearfield kind of brings that out in me too. I hate this town.
They're not used to seeing somebody this pretty. At least a male this pretty.
That's what it is. They don't show any respect. They cheer facade over me. You know, you'll get some old school.
You gotta respect facade, but be that as it may, Taylor will make you respect him. 2-0.
Mark Gussel's a strong man, but I don't know what he's thinking. Trying to body slam the earthquake. That man.
I'll tell you what.
That man is like 600 pounds. He's like Yokozuna, babe.
Cage Fury should have been Dalton Castle's night. All intents and purposes, you thought the moon and the stars were aligning. But again, Team Big League promised no interference. Joe Brooks getting involved. And even a steel cage could not keep Team Big League at bay. But what is supposed to make us think that Team Big League's own executive consultant, North Connors, as the special referee, is going to keep any outside interference out of this matchup? Especially, it's Norm. We both worked for him.
Look at his history. His track record speaks for itself. I remember a call to arms 2009 where he hit me in the head with a hammer on the biggest show he ever ran. Screwed me out of my heavyweight title. Hit me with a hammer. This guy can't be trusted, and he's gonna be the referee for the biggest title match of the year.
And Taylor elevating Castle to the outside. Jeez. And Castle had no apron, nothing. He just landed flat on this hard, unprotected floor.
Two. That might be it. A hard spill that he took on the floor. And Earthquake might have this match won by countout. I don't see how Dalton's going to get up from that. And if he does recover, he's definitely not going to be at 100% for the remainder of this match.
And this could be 10. Dalton, it might be a wise idea to take the count out. Save yourself for McChesney, but Dalton doesn't think like that.
Girthquake should be on him right now.
Royalty on a Girthquake name? Roll up by Castle, 2-0.
He'll always be the Girthquake to me.
Well, he's a lot of things to a lot of people. He's dangerous to everybody. Castle trying to catch him off guard. Oh, God!
That's it. If the spill to the floor and that lariat might have done it.
And keep in mind, Taylor is a man who beat four men 3 weeks ago. By himself, handling.
I mean, those are hardly men, but
well, dudes, four, cover four. 2-0. He beat four competitors.
There you go.
He beat four members of this roster. You take any four members of this roster, I don't care who they are, they're formidable.
I think I can take the STDs 4-1.
Well, I have a line for that, but I'll move on. Taylor right down to the sternum. Overwhelming power. The simplest basic things that Taylor does. That's all he needs to do sometimes.
Trust me, it is all he needs to do. I have never been hit so hard in my career than I have by Shane Taylor.
There's a cover. Now, what are the odds, Zima, for Dalton Castle? Factor in this Taylor match, factor in Norm, McChesney, longest reigning IWC champion cumulatively in the history of the company. Dalton has come up short so many times through no fault of his own. Could December be the magic time?
If the odds were not stacked against him before, they're stacked even more now. It's like he's had steel cages, he's had multiple opportunities, interference. Now he's got Norm as the referee, and he's got to deal with Shane Taylor right now before he even gets there. I don't know how Dalton is going to get past December.
Oh. Both men jockeying for leverage. No surprise, Taylor wins out. Gets two on the belly to belly. My God. Never thought I'd see Shane Taylor back for an IWC to begin with, let alone the path of destruction he's caused. Taylor and Logan Shulo coming up at winner take all. What a collision that's going to be. Two of the biggest men in this organization's history, really.
Yeah, absolutely. It's definitely going to be a brutal match. December 14th is shaping up to be a hell of a cookie, actually.
Absolutely. It's routinely among the best in IWC throughout the calendar year, but I think we're taking it to a whole new level here in 2013.
Absolutely. I finally get my hands on RJ City.
Great to see that matchup finally signed, and certainly contractually obligated to show up this time, unlike tonight.
Yeah, I thought he was supposed to be here tonight.
There you go. Well,
that's why I showed up.
Second time we've seen RJ supposed to be here and not when you're here. But when you're not supposed to be here, you show up anyway.
It's very interesting. I'm like a ninja. Not to be confused with a neon ninja.
No. But that shows me how bad you want it. You want a piece of RJ City, he didn't want a piece of you.
Of course he doesn't. He'll find that out in December. All this trash talking he's been doing, he'll wish he never opened his mouth and tried to make a name for himself at my expense.
I'll have him singing in a different octave.
I like that. But enough about that. Let's talk about Dalton Castle lighting up Shane Taylor.
Dalton's the man that could end the stranglehold Team Bigley has in the championship if Team Bigley doesn't strangle him first. Oh, my God.
Look at that. Dalton Castle, it takes him 4 shots to stagger Shane Taylor. Shane Taylor, one shot to shut down Dalton Castle. That just shows you the strength this man is packing behind his punches.
I've never seen one shot take down Dalton Castle before. A big man in his own right, but you couldn't tell based on him matching up to Shane Taylor.
Yeah. That is very true. Both men also have a collegiate wrestling background. Did you know that? I've done a little research.
Well, I knew that about Dalton, but certainly not.
The Girthquake as well.
Not about Shane Taylor. Not that he needs it quite
necessarily. We should book them in an amateur wrestling match.
Well, good luck finding a pair of headgear that will fit Shane Taylor.
Or a singlet. Well, I guess he's wearing a singlet now.
Taylor for the second turnbuckle. This could be it for Dalton.
If this happens.
We saw Plummer carried out. Dalton may join him. And this man's quick on his feet as well. Countered. But Dalton out of the way. And can the charismatic milkshake, if you will, get the tides back on his side? Castle has a big man's
German? I don't think so. I don't think so.
Well, Dalton specializes in that deadlift German, but man.
He ain't deadlifting that.
Not in the least.
Well, he wants to throw his back out before December.
Yeah, gotta think about the future, Dalton. Up and over.
What is that? Oh.
Little tap on the keister and the Bulldog follow through.
And he's got these people firmly behind him.
For the first time ever, Shane Taylor's thrown off his game.
He's out on his feet right now. Oh, no.
He got him. Shane slam.
Shane's a Luger on the SS Intrepid Joseph.
That wasn't enough. Shane Taylor kicked that, and a man that's not used to being body slammed, a man with a move like that, your weight works against you on the impact, Taylor's still able to kick out.
I am firmly on the Dalton Express right now.
I gotcha.
You didn't react.
Well, I'm reacting to Dalton Castle right now.
Oh.
And Taylor, taste of Dalton's own medicine, perhaps. Jeez, and again, one shot.
One shot shuts him down. That's a one-hitter quitter.
All that momentum, stunted. And a huge hammock of a leg. Good grief.
I have no idea how Dalton Castle is still in this match. That just goes to show you his tenacity.
Amazing that he kicked out of that. Amazing. Yeah. And again, you got to believe he's looking forward to John McChesney and Norm Thomas, the special referee.
That may be the only thing that's keeping him going right now is his drive.
Yeah. You want that momentum for that psychological purpose, if nothing else. If Dalton loses before John McChesney, it's going to be that little cup of the road. Sunset flap, Dalton! Dalton!
He just beat him.
He just pinned Shane Taylor.
Unbelievable. Yeah, Dalton, get out of that ring as fast as you can.
And I can't remember the last time I saw Shane Taylor get pinned.
I can't either. I don't think he's ever been pinned in Clearfield, no less.
It's been years, but Dalton gets the job done.
But there, look, McChesney.
Oh, no, come on. McChesney from behind. Well, Dalton proved he could do it.
Now he's feeding him to an even more angry Shane Taylor right now.
Dalton proved he could survive a near impossible series of odds. But it will be even worse at Winner Take All. Oh, McChesney. And again, who's pulling the strings here? Who's running this operation? No!
Oh.
Dalton is out.
What do you think of that, Clearfield? Yeah, boo me all you want, but I'm the IWC champion, the best man in this building right now. I will still be the IWC champion.
Will it be a fair fight? Norm Connors says yes. I have some huge doubts.
Is it ever a fair fight with Team Big League Joseph?
Absolutely not.
So Don Castle's got a lot of odds stacked against him for December 14th.
Don't survive tonight.
Barely.
The journey he's been fighting for over a year to get that IWC championship. He may have one final crack, and it may not be under the terms he ever would have wanted, but it's the terms he has to deal with. Dalton Schacht at Winner Take All.
All right, that seems good. All right, we want to thank everybody. There we go. We want to thank you kids very much for helping bring IWC. So let's get everybody out of the ring. Wrestlers, get to the back. And how about all the little brothers, little sisters, how about you guys stand right here? Because I know there's somebody that wants something to say to you guys. So why don't you stand right here, all right? And you stand on the outside of the ring. And ladies and gentlemen, before I hand the mic over to one of our superstars here tonight who wants to address these kids, I just want to say from all of us at IWC, we want to thank you so much for coming here tonight. We want to thank you for welcoming IWC back to Clearfield. Do you guys want us to come back next year? I've already talked to Sean Tischler. We've already worked out two dates. We'll be back here in the spring. We'll be coming back on Saturday night, March the 1st. So IWC comes back here. Check out our website coming up. You'll see all of our future show dates. Ladies and gentlemen, right now at this time, I'd like to hand the microphone over to one of the founding fathers and five-time IWC heavyweight champion, Dennis Gregory.
Thank you, Mr. Robbins. I want to take a second. I know there's been a lot of talking tonight and raffles and conversations going on about the big brothers and the big sisters, but I want to say that everybody who wears this shirt says the founding fathers on the back of it. And those guys in this promotion took a stand to support and help mentor the guys that come into the wrestling business and teach them the right way. And I just want you to know that the guys who wear this shirt are the good guys here tonight for you guys, okay? But to you boys and girls, I want to say that, well, why this matters to me. When I was in eighth grade, I was, I was underprivileged, but we didn't call it that back then. They just said I was a jag-off. And, I definitely was. But I had a guy who stepped in and, you know, I wasn't able to get in with the big brothers and big sisters, but I had a guy who stepped in who I felt was my mentor, but everybody else called him the Honorable Judge Jeff Murray, who said that I needed to clean up, fix up, and do right, okay? And I didn't listen at first, I was a tough seed, and after a while I finally figured it out, right out of high school. I left a troubled home, and I don't want to scare you kids because Halloween's over, but my dad was an alcoholic. He beat me harder than anybody gets beat in this match, in this show here tonight for you guys. But right out of high school, I left for the military. And with Veterans Day coming up, I thought it was appropriate to say so that I've done 4 deployments, and everybody who's gone with me and comes back, what we say is, why do you do it? We do it for the freedom, and we do it for people who deserve it. And you kids deserve it, okay? You guys are lucky to have a program of big brothers and big sisters. You really are. And you know, it's so nervous for you guys and girls, okay? So when you think you ain't getting, I'm getting a little bit choked up here, but when you think you aren't getting a fair shake and a fair deal, realize some of it's up to you too. This night and all these adults here and all these guys working are doing this for you because you do matter, all right? And you gotta matter enough for you to do the heavy lifting too. When life is rough, and people are trying to challenge you the easy way out, you gotta tell them, that ain't the way for me, all right? You gotta matter that much to you, okay? So I just want you guys to know that it is possible. No matter what hand you're dealt, you can still do what's right. It's your choice to do what you want. And I know you get that ear beating a lot, but I'm proof that it does happen and it does work, okay? So I just wanna say that, to me, I appreciate the big brothers and big sisters. I wish I had that route to go when I was some of your age, okay? I would say, for me personally, God bless the boys and girls, the big brothers and big sisters, and God bless America. I'm not going to really sell out to you guys and say God bless Clearfield, so don't take it personal.
But I do have one more thing to say.
What is this?
Dennis Gregory with a heartfelt message to the big brothers and big sisters that's helping us out here tonight. Combat in Clearfield 5 live event, and Joseph Brooks and his C4 confetti gun, his bad blaster, if you will. Very unwelcome intrusion into these proceedings.
Hello? Hello? Is this thing on? Hello? Hello? Can you hear me now? Because when I came out here, I had confetti. You people talk about these kids. They deserve more. I bought them a present. I bought a confetti cannon.
Shut the hell up.
What did you say to me? What did you just say to me? You do not get a confetti cannon.
I think he said shut the hell up.
Take this, put it over there. I'm going to celebrate tonight when I win. Shut your mouth. I was in back, I'm not going to lie to you. I got a little choked up.
No one cares about your story.
Why don't you sit and wait patiently? That's the problem with children today. You have no understanding of manners. These kids, you say they deserve something, they deserve nothing. You shut up!
Shut up!
I'm okay.
It's real nice that on a night of a show that's about the kids, you're gonna make it about you. You got a mic, there's an off button you choose not to use, so spit what you wanna spit and get it over with.
I got something to say. Why'd you come here? This is important. I want to make sure you hear this loud and clear. I have a message for you. And I want this message to resonate. I know for you kids that's a big word. I want this message to get across. Look me in the eye. You see it?
Oh, come on. A literal and figurative slap in the face of Dennis Gregory. And the chase is on. And Bell sounds, and it's Brooks and Dennis Gregory, one-on-one, founding fathers, versus Team Big League. Joined now once again by Aiden Bale. We Are Rock Stars, somebody who certainly is great to shed some insight on Joseph Brooks in this matchup. And certainly you know all about the disrespectful nature of Mr. Brooks.
You know what, man? I don't even know if I want to talk during this guy's match, man. This guy is disgusting. I can't wait to get my hands on him and G-Nuts again.
Well, maybe, maybe living a little bit of vicariousness through Dennis Gregory, huh?
Hey, I do like Dennis.
And Brooks on the outside. Brooks without his partner, Jimmy Nuts. Of course, knee injury suffered at Retro Reunion.
See, that's just it, man. Jimmy Nuts has no respect for this company. Look at me, man. I could be laid up right now. I can't wrestle for 6 months. Jimmy Nuts can't wrestle. Where is he? I'm here. Why can't he be here?
It's true. Jimmy Nuts maybe has his own issues to deal with. Maybe he's with Norm Connors, whoever Norm is. The executive consultant of Team Big League. As Norm has said, that Jimmy Nuts has really been the only member of Team Big League that stays in frequent communication with him.
He knows how to play the game. I'll give him that.
Come on!
And Brooks now punishing Dennis Gregory. Brooks, another one not a favorite of these Clearfield faithful.
Get them all rallied.
And Dennis Gregory, you gotta believe, thrown off his game. Didn't expect to start his matchup the way he did against Joseph Brooks. But Brooks is very cagey, he's very resourceful, and certainly under that Team Big League learning tree for the past year or so. has really done a lot of wonders for Brooks' career.
I hate to say, but this guy is pretty special.
You can't deny it. You want to, but you can't. The tag team championship.
This kid got an answer for everything.
The tag team championship Brooks wore so proudly. We don't really have a prognosis on the condition of Jimmy Nuts. The state of the tag team championship is really an issue that we haven't heard any news about from IWC management, Chuck Roberts.
Keep it a secret. I don't even care. As long as he's out, that's all that matters.
Well, you certainly have to be hoping for, and certainly, again, not that I would condone this, but hoping for some type of injury that would keep Nuts out of action for a number of months. Perhaps to see a tournament of some sort you can compete in.
See, that's it. He's smart, though. Joe Brooks is smart, but he doesn't use his brain to his power. It's to his advantage, I guess. Look at this.
Well, Aiden, I appreciate you attempting to take the high road on the Jimmy Nuts situation. I know I can tell that you are. You're attempting to take the high road on the Jimmy Nuts situation, but we can certainly see that you're still stewing over it.
I do like stewing.
It's grinding those white teeth together. Brooks is wearing away at Gregory now. Reverse chin lock. Cuts off the blood supply to the brain via the carotid artery. Focusing in on where the ramus of the mandible articulates with the mandibular fossa of the temporal bone.
What?
And Gregory up to a vertical base. And Brooks backed into the court. Check out that power on the veteran.
Still got him, man.
Five-time IWC champion. Can't break the hold. And look where Gregory lands up again. Dead center of the ring.
And he's still got some fight on him. Broke it for a second, but he still got it.
Well, Brooks is tenacious. And he's got all the body weight. His own body weight, those Brooks. Wearing down, driving Gregory down to the canvas. Gregory, desperation over, finally gets the job done, and the grasp is broken.
Took a lot out of him.
Yeah, Gregory, you can certainly see, not all there. Has to shake the cobwebs. Brooks hanging on. Hurt himself coming back in the ring. That wasn't very smart. That's what happens when you don't listen to Norm, I guess. Roll up. Brooks gonna steal this in front of the big brothers and sisters, but only a close
5 minutes
two.
5 minutes gone by in this contest. 5 minutes.
And Brooks landed right on his Jimmy Nuts a minute ago. Gregory, the fireman's carry. Airplane spin coming up. Going to the old school.
In the Air Force?
Thrust kick to the front of the jaw! Gregory, get out of there! No!
Close, but how do you say it? No cigar.
I don't say that. Okay, maybe I do.
You can start.
Brooks regretting opening his mouth now, that's for sure. Went to finish this thing off, but Gregory shoves him aside. Now, powerbomb coming up. No. Face first, throw first. That's a little old school Gregory. Roll up. Got it. Oh.
Here is your machine,
and you know what? He did it for the kids. The founding fathers are ruthless individuals, but we found a soft side in Denny Gregory.
What a key.
Gregory victorious to the big brothers and big sisters, but Joseph Brooks gonna take a loss back to Team Big League. That won't do any wonders. That won't help the potential splinters forming in that faction. Up next, big 8-man tag team action here at Combat Clearfield 5. Tag team champion Bobby Fish, a lot to talk about this matchup and a very unique time he's chosen to join us.
Yeah, from what I've seen.
868 pounds,
Here's the team of Corey DeJersey, Brian Hakeem Penn McDowell, and Chris Fletcher, the STDs, and their tag team partner, Ruby Lemay.
Don't think there was anything like this in Pro Wrestling Noah, was there?
No, Joe, I feel like I fell asleep and I woke up on the Island of Misfit Toys here.
That's a good way to put it.
What exactly is getting in that ring?
I'd like to introduce all of you people to somebody. Get in the ring, everybody get in the ring.
Some old woman's missing her bed. She's doing what Fletcher's doing.
I think so, yeah. I mean, is he ready for bed? Has he brushed his teeth yet? They look like someone's pajamas.
And he has finally joined up with the people that he belongs with. He is now a member of the STDs.
That's sexy, talented dudes for everybody at home.
All right. I like how they did that, huh? Really.
You cured an STD earlier tonight with former Andrew Powell.
I did. It was the least I could do for Clearfield.
Fortunately, it's the kind that keeps coming back. Go to Pedro. For the introduction of the very eclectic opposing team.
He is on his own side by Magnificent Madison. They went in to run at 915 pounds. Here's the team of Sam Cassidy, Marco McBride, the Bearcat Peacock, and Musso the Bull.
Well, you want to talk about diverse personalities.
Yeah, Joe, I'm near speechless over here. There's a guy with a Confederate flag and a cowboy hat alongside a shirtless man wearing a scarf, and then somebody who looks like he just got off of work and he's on his way to happy hour.
That is Sam Cassidy, Pete Hawk, Russell McBride, and Marshall the Bull. There's a lot of tag team championship reigns between them on that team, but all with other people.
Yeah, this is an interesting collection that's in that ring right now.
I feel like calling Unsolved Mysteries and telling them I found everybody.
Well, I don't see how it's possible for this match not to deliver with that eclectic a bunch standing before us.
What it's delivering, I'm not sure.
Exactly. Exactly. Well said, Joe.
Fletcher, now tell the world what you think of his dancing.
I think your dancing is a joke.
Burn.
I challenge you to a dance off right now.
Oh, no.
Oh, man.
Knows how to dance.
It's just got better.
Oh, where's Tracy Smothers when you need him?
I don't want to dance with you. I want to dance with Ginger.
Ginger?
Ginger!
Keith Hawk and Ginger in a dance-off. Keith Hawk, of course, the frequent tag partner of Colin Delaney. They're former tag champions together.
The question is it a dance-off or is he going to dance with her?
That's a good question.
That's two different kinds of dance.
He thought by himself is two different kinds of dancing, but how well he moves.
A lot of shake in that ring right now.
Oh,
I think he's gonna hurt himself here.
Divert your eyes.
There's children here, Joe. I don't know if that was, I don't know if he expected somebody to stuff a dollar bill in his pants, but I saw that move at a club down the street earlier tonight.
Oh my God. What happened to my life?
I don't know.
Keith Hawk slams Corey Futuristic. This matchup has started. Corey Futuristic claims he's from the future. He claims time travel.
We are underway.
Oh my God. Huge elevation of the back body drop.
Oh, boy.
It's Hawk tagging out to Marshall the Bull, former five-time IWC tag champion.
Okay, so am I understanding these rules properly? Two people in at a time? I just saw a double tag.
I hope not. There's a hip lock to Corey Futuristic.
Is the referee hiding under the ring? Who's here to keep order?
For the ride.
Oh!
Hey, guys, can I get in on this?
Dalton Castle now joining us as well, as I have officially lost control of this entire show.
Well, I saw Bobby Fish walking out here. He likes to talk, and I like to talk. So I thought, why don't we get out here and talk?
Dalton, briefly, how are you feeling after the attack of Shane Taylor?
I was beat up a little bit. Oh, by the way, Bobby, can you get a handle on your jerks in Team Big League? Do you really like those guys?
To be honest, I'm a little distracted right now. There's quite the car wreck going on in this ring.
Brian McDowell, the bowling enthusiast, in there with Keith Hawk, former tag team champion.
Do car wrecks usually do belly-to-belly suplexes?
In bowling shorts, no less.
Tag into Remy LeVay, not much known about this newcomer, graduate of the ICWA, Iron City Wrestling Academy.
Remington Steel. Wow.
Bobby Fish, Dalton brings up a good point about Team Big League. Last time we saw you with them, you were on opposite sides of the ring with John McChesney. Have you guys spoken since that matchup at Retro Reunion?
Yeah, of course we have. We're always in contact. I think everything's been squared away, and things are fine with myself and Team Big League.
Well, what about the fact that we
see... this is a unique... Bobby, I just want to get this out of the way. Obviously, the elephant in the room here is Keith Hawk, but the other elephant in the room here is... You and I have no beef, right? I just want to make sure that's... Like, I understand you're with those garbage...
I'm a vegetarian.
Okay, so... This...
Way to avoid that question.
Are we okay? We can do this?
Yeah. I think yes.
As a performer, a wrestler, and an avid CrossFitter.
All right, we're on the same page, but we got to call the match now. Because Fletcher in there with Sam Cassidy.
Oh, one hell of a drop
kick. We got our podcast canceled.
Podcast.
And a Freudian slip.
Sam Cassidy, Chess Fletcher tags out to Remy.
That's Chess Fletcher or a lampshade.
But either or at this point.
Sam
has to deal with the aggression and frustration over losing his trainer, Justin Idol, who joined the Founding Fathers. Quick cover on Remy.
Remington Steel caught that right in the chest.
Quickly from you, Bobby Fish. We see that two different stories from the camp of Team Big League. One from John McChesney, one from Norm Connors. Who's in charge here?
I don't know myself. Ever since Norm came into the mix, things have been a little topsy-turvy, and then I can't make a whole lot of sense of this. So I try to do my thing, but John and I are fine.
Remy goes for the cover. Count of two, no. Seen you guys weren't fine at Mountain State Madness, but I'll take your word for it. We'll pursue onward as Remy LeVay and Sam Cassidy, two rookies, looking to get themselves known in a matchup with a lot of IWC prestige along with it.
Remy's got the upper hand here because it looked like he's used the hand drum technique from Karate Kid 2 quite a bit.
That's not a technique to be taken lightly, and last time I checked, there's only 63 Americans who actually know that technique.
Keith Hawk's in the ring. He thinks this is his turn to wrestle.
Well, Keith Hawk's gonna get out of the ring.
Keith Hawk doesn't know the rules.
Keith Hawk's a former tag champion.
He's just hungry for some action.
I think he is. Tag into the bowling enthusiast, Brian McDowell.
Does he not play? He just likes it?
Oh, he plays it. He's the kingpin. Got a strike there with Cassidy. Cover. And McDowell's got a lot of power. Keep in mind, he was recruited by Marshall to be his tag team partner at the main event of Mountain State Madness 5.
I thought you meant Marshall University.
Against the Color Slaughterhouse.
You see that sidewalk slam there? A bowler has a lot of strength in their hip.
He's got strength to spare.
See what you did there?
Rolls a big elbow. Could get him here. Count of one. Everybody in interrupt.
Well, that's what you gotta do. You wanna win. This guy just got off happy hour.
There's some bad blood from that cage match.
Look at that closed fist.
Marshall Gambino, the veteran, in there with McDowell. Bad blood from their cage match.
Looks like clothes you wear to work.
Well, hurting people is Marshall Gambino's occupation, for sure. Don't mess with a Gambino, gentlemen. You'll be at the bottom of the river.
Gambino's occupation is hurting people and showing off the top of his chest.
Some rolled up carpets in there, too.
What's the bottom of your chest?
5 minutes, like 5 minutes.
Double drop kick, not the prettiest thing in the world, but man, that'll get the job done for McDowell.
This referee has a lenient grasp on these rules.
And this lampshade, though, he is my favorite today. I think I'm going with the lampshade today.
The lampshade has a name. He's Chess Fletcher and he's an STD.
I thought his name was Pajama Pants.
That should work too. smothering Cassidy. Yes, Dalton.
Well, I just want to say the technique here to keep the guy away from his teammates.
Dare I say shades of the Andersons in this match.
Do you think this lamb shake gets an idea of his butt lights up?
This is Minnesota Wrecking Crew-esque.
Did Ole ever wear pants like that?
I think he did, but he's going to bed. He wore a nightcap with it.
Making a wish, Flexor and futuristic.
Now tell me about Corey futuristic.
You think she's from the future?
Thinks or he is?
I don't have proof.
Because those look like futuristic pants.
They do.
It looks like his pants are wrapped in cellophane.
If he's from the
future, fresh.
Yeah. If he's from
the fresh. Come on, Sam.
If he's from the future, I think evolution's going the opposite direction.
Oh,
jeez. He just go back in time and not die. He just died. That's a dead guy. There's a dead. Why is he moving?
Cassidy looking for the tag. Flexor in as is Big Bronco, Blue Collar.
Get him out of there, that's a corpse.
And now the mood changes.
No! Oh my God!
Bronco. Stacking up the bodies. There's an easy joke in here I'm not gonna make.
Yeah, a necrophilia joke.
What a little too bad. Remy to the outside. Oh no. For the ride? And McDowell gonna get involved. Going for a hot.
McDowell, he used to pitch for the Mets.
He's a safe guy.
He also coined the Big Mac. And the quarter pounder.
Cassidy gonna fly!
Coming to America. What was the name
Springboard
of that?
Springboard
Fly. Yes.
Oh, you guys are too
McDowell's.
Much.
McDowell's.
The Big Mick.
There's Bronco. Gonna scale a turbo.
I can't get over the fact that Corey Futuristic is still moving.
Me either.
Maybe not after this.
No, well, yeah.
Here we go. This is smart. This is smart. Teaming up. They're not very big boys, but together.
Fletcher yelled out double superplex.
What exactly is going on here?
Oh my God.
He just shoved his head up.
This looks like a totem pole.
It's usually up his own rear end. Oh my God.
I don't want to be here.
Oh, this isn't
I don't
want to
witness
well.
This. The cops are going to ask me what happened, and I'm closing my eyes.
Bronco! Bronco! Demolition Derby here at Clearfield.
That was, if I'm not mistaken, a double doomsday device.
That's a great call.
Out, right?
That's a great call.
Two doomsdays make a right.
Yeah.
Well, it went very wrong for the sexy talented dudes.
Two lefts make a right.
Keith Hutt, right to the temple.
Keith Hutt seems to be the only person who can connect precision on those big boy kicks.
Right.
All the way to the top.
It's time for the hot mess.
Hot mess? That's what he calls it?
Woo!
Oh, the hot mess. I think we got ourselves a three count.
I called Keith out at the beginning. Record shows it.
I officially love that finishing maneuver, the hot mess.
We have seen something that we will not soon forget, gentlemen.
No way. Either that or we've set the business back 10 years.
Marshall Gambino, Bronco McBride, Keith Hutt, and Sam Cassidy. Eight-man tag. They thwarted the STDs.
They did.
Another good dance.
Like a good antibiotic, Dave.
Like a shot of penicillin.
There you go.
Straight to the
there you go.
Ladies and gentlemen, two matches still to go. Somehow we're not done. Combat Clearfield continues. Well, we are set for one of the most anticipated matchups of the evening. The unbreakable Michael Elgin, one of the most foreboding and intimidating entities in professional wrestling today. And Bobby Fish, you know well, an individual who was really just a hair away at one point from being the next Ring of Honor World Champion.
He had just missed it. Adam Cole ended up pulling it out, but I think Michael Elgin gave him all he could handle, and then some. I'm not very fond of the guy. I don't care for him. There's no secret about that. But you have to respect what he's capable of in that ring.
And there's really no other athlete in professional wrestling built quite like Elgin.
No, closest thing I can think of is maybe Rhino. But yeah, very compact, very powerful guy. Tree trunk legs.
This is a great test for Logan Shulo, though, the heavy metal Jesus. Somebody, again, you as part of Team Big League, very well acquainted with. Logan Shulo will face Team Big League's 375-pound enforcer, Shane Taylor, at Winner Take All on December 14th. And few men come as powerful as Shane Taylor, but if you're going to make an argument of one who might, it's Michael Elgin. So great match for Logan here tonight.
Yeah, I think Logan's going to be able to take a lot of what he encounters tonight into that contest coming up. There's a lot of similarities between the two.
The question is Logan Shulo 100%? Back at Friday Night Fights, when Taylor made his return, bailed out John McChesney, Shulo was splashed multiple times, injured, missed Retro Reunion as a result. This is Shulo's first matchup since that vicious attack about 6 weeks ago.
I can't say. I'm not his doctor, nor do we hang out much, but he looks to be in fantastic shape.
Absolutely. He's certainly been spending ample time in the gym preparing for this return, and you know when you are in a matchup with Elgin, you're in for a fight.
Yeah, certainly in for a fight. That's one thing that you know. Elgin's going to give you everything that you want.
And keep in mind, Elgin is not a stereotypical bigger guy. He can move, and his most important asset, I think, is endurance, because Elgin is more conditioned than most of the athletes in this business have to say.
Yeah, you generally don't get a guy in quite as thick as Elgin, who can carry his weight as well as he does without the cardiovascular system kind of giving out and failing him, especially towards the end of these longer matches.
Collar and elbow, you can see Logan just putting all the oomph, all the effort he can just to get Elgin back into the corner.
Yeah, well, and if you notice, he had to really get low on him there to get the leverage required to back Elgin up, as his center of gravity is so low, he almost becomes that immovable object.
And Elgin taking a breather on the outside. Maybe not a breather, but more of a regrouping strategy.
Yeah, I think that's more of a head game than anything else. And Shulo, he's been around the block, but I think Elgin is going to try to employ some of those head game tactics here to gain the advantage.
Well, it's what we talked about a little bit in your match with Andrew Palace, how, in my opinion, you almost had Palace beat before the bell rang. He's got this crowd in his case, he got inside the guy's head.
Yeah, I mean, Joe, it's no secret I'm a master strategist. And, I think Elgin would serve himself well to take a page from my book, which is really, I guess, the only book that matters at this point, in this match here with Shulo.
Shulo for the rod. Elgin cuts him off. Elgin, arguably the most dominant Ring of Honor athlete throughout 2013, won the number one contendership back at Supercard of Honor earlier this year and kept it for so many months up until that championship tournament, where we finally saw Adam Cole, IWC alum in his own right, chosen as champion. And Shulo, now with the armbar, the arm ringer, and Adam Cole will have big problems with Elgin in the months ahead, but Logan Shulo having big problems here tonight. Full house here, Mike Fassad, I should say, joining us as well. What is your take on this matchup as well, because you know Logan Shulo better than anybody, especially here in this building.
Myself and Logan Shulo, we have been in this building. We went round and round a couple of times. We took each other to the limit, time limit, 20-minute time limit last time we were here. And, you know, I train with him every day, or every week, rather. We go down to the ring, we get it in, and, you know, he's coming into a league of his own right now.
Yeah, it's really great you guys have been such a competitive rivalry, but still closeness outside the ring. But certainly, The difference between a facade and an Elgin is monumental in that ring.
I mean, the Canadian Crazy Horse, he's got power for days, and Logan Shulo can only hope to combat his power with the speed and agility that he can bring as the elite athlete.
And something I was discussing with Mr. Fish, that's the endurance that Elgin has, which is not like anybody else built like Michael Elgin, but certainly as you have gone through a 20-minute draw with Shulo, you can attest to Shulo having much the same.
Absolutely.
Shulo now controlling the arm. Elgin's a man who's built so thick and so compact, you're not going to find a weak point on him. You're going to have to create one. And Shulo knows that. And Mr. Facade, you've also had your run-ins over the years with Shane Taylor, I'm certainly sure about. And how does one prepare for 375 pounds of bad attitude?
You don't prepare. You go in there, you say your prayers, you just go in there and do your thing. You can only hope to outsmart him, outquick him, because if you try to go toe-to-toe with power with that man, you're surely going to lose. Even the Canadian Crazy Horse, Michael Elgin, can attest to that.
Well, it certainly may take divine intervention for the heavy metal Jesus as he catches himself on the apron. Elgin sends Shulo hard into the guardrail. And again, that's not just anybody pushing into that guardrail. That's 250 pounds plus of Elgin power. Now, Facade, have you had any conversation with Shulo about his physical state? First time you've seen him since Friday Night Fights about 6 weeks ago, he was seriously injured by Taylor.
Yeah, he's seriously injured. You know, he had quite the dinged up leg. I don't know the extent of that, but I know that he's still nursing that injury. I don't know if that's going to come into play here, but, you know, I've been in the ring with Michael Elgin myself, and I can tell you what, that he will exploit any opportunity he can to get the upper hand and then some.
Grinding Shulo's face on that ring post. Logan Shulo talked earlier about a major announcement he was about to deliver before he was interrupted by Justin LaBarre and Shane Taylor. Still no word on what that might have been, but whatever future announcement Shulo has, he just has to live to make it that far.
That is the key, my friend.
5 minutes gone behind this contest. 5 minutes.
Bobby Fish. What do we got to do to beat Michael Elgin? You are a student of the game. You've been all over the world. Talk to me. Give me some strategy.
You're going to have to pick a body part, zero in on that body part. Me, personally, I'm going to the legs. I'm going to try to work on a joint. I'm going right to the knee. I'm going to stay away from those massive quads that you can see him carrying around. And I'm going to go straight to the knee. I'm going to try to take out a wheel.
It's a whole lot of meat on that man.
Again, so compact, so thick, tough to maneuver the guy. That center of gravity comes into play for Elgin.
Like I said before, Joe, if you watched earlier on the collar and elbow, Shulo, in order to back Elgin to the corner, had to almost get lower than Elgin because his center of gravity is so low, he becomes an object that you can't put him where you want him. He's not going any place he doesn't want to go.
It's a pillar of power, if you will.
Or the old cliched immovable object.
Yes, exactly.
And I don't think Elgin gets along with Clearfield. Elgin not used to having the unofficial home field advantage. Wildly popular in Ring of Honor, but these fans have watched Logan grow up over the past 3 or 4 years.
Yeah, that's true. Being familiar with the area, they're certainly solid behind Shulo here tonight.
Shulo gets the foot up. Elgin is dazed to a knee briefly, but right back onto his feet.
Seems like Shulo's having a little bit of success with some shucking and jiving. He's got a zig and zag on Elgin here. And
bringing the intensity. Shulo's probably a hair or two quicker. Dropping the senton, could do it here. Number two and no.
He appears to be feeling it, and Shulo's got to capitalize on this. Keep that momentum going. He can't let it drop back down. He's picked up the pace, and slowing it down like this, personally, I thought this is a mistake.
Could be a big story if Logan can pin Elgin. I'm not sure if Elgin's had more than one or two pinfall losses in the past year. Elgin went paddle, cutter, roll, counter. And straight left of Shulo. That's raw power. The leverage was adverse to Elgin, but was still able to elevate Shulo.
Shulo left him too much room. He left a gap open, and Elgin's going to take advantage of that. I mean, come on. This is not this guy's first rodeo.
I'm not sure that Shulo's, as we talked about, there's nobody like Elgin. Shulo's never faced a man like this. This is a trial and error.
Well, and at that point, if that's the case, then when you gain the advantage like you did a minute ago, he's got to stay on him. I mean, he's a talented athlete.
Could be the Elgin bomb. Shulo scouts it. Elgin's televised in 50 markets. Shulo's got a lot of footage to go on. But Elgin, again, just a straight deadlift of Logan Shulo.
Heavy metal Jesus is in a bad way now.
To be sure.
Elgin going to the top.
With any other man this size, you'd think mistake. For Elgin, you think the end. God. Twisting senton! But Shulo sidesteps!
For the thought, such a powerful man can fly.
Oh, Shulo has his opening. Elgin defies so many men's expectation, but Shulo did not underestimate it. Not on this occasion. And Shulo trying to elevate Elgin, nothing doing. Keep in mind, a match like this, it's powerbomb versus powerbomb. Halo bomb versus Elgin bomb. And it's Shulo. Oh,
quite a, with a knee strike.
Quite a con between the eyes.
Oh, he almost had him there, Joe.
Elgin had a faraway look in his eye. Looked like he was out on his feet for a moment.
Yeah, I think that knee caught him right under the chin, caught him right on the button.
Elgin may be working on instinct. Shulo is measuring Elgin.
And again, I think it's a similar mistake as before, though. You got to close in. This is already, he got burnt once by this.
He's telegraphing that big old discus lariat.
Yeah, Elgin doesn't see it, though. Elgin dazed. Discovered it in time. Bicycle kick. These two men still jockeying for position, center of the ring. And it's Elgin who gets the upper hand for a moment. Look out! Shulo tried to catch himself, but he may have wrenched his leg. Yeah, that's a great call. Shulo, ever with deceptive agility, tried to catch himself. Oh no. Now this defies any logic here. This defies what normal humans can do. The leverage is so far against Elgin. But he's elevated so many. Shulo fighting it, has a death grip on the turnbuckle. And Elgin hits back of the head first.
Elgin looks like he might be out here.
And I'm not sure if Elgin had ever tried that suplex on a man as big as Shulo. Again, the vertical leap is staggering from both these gentlemen. And Elgin.
Both men fighting on top.
Shulo's got to be 230 or 40. Elgin is an absolute powerhouse, but not much room to go in the second turnbuckle. My God. Neck first. Coverdo.
Get that pin.
Drops him from the top right on his head.
And Elgin, a rare mistake. Underestimation, he thought this was over. And Bobby Fish, you know better than just about anybody, you and McChesney, you can never count Logan Shulo out.
No, you certainly can. I think Elgin could have maybe hooked that leg a little bit tighter to secure that pin, but he left enough room. And
Elgin bomb!
Goes out.
No, Shulo able to shift the weight. Got the knee again. He strikes to the head, seem to be doing something.
He hits the lariat.
No matter how big you are, that brain can be hurt. And Shulo got it.
What a combination of attacks by Shulo. Get the bicycle kick, the knee strike. And the big old discus lariat.
Shulo had that at the bottom of his playbook. Tried to break down a couple times, didn't work. But those shots to the head. Dazed the big man. And the unbreakable one, momentarily broken by Logan Shulo. But Vasad, can he do the same to an even bigger man in Shane Taylor?
That's a question I don't even have the answer to, Joe Dombrowski.
Bobby Fish, you've been on the road with Elgin as part of Ring of Honor. You know how tough this man is. What does it mean that Logan Shulo pinned him in the center of the ring?
That's a huge win for Logan Shulo. It was only a month ago that Elgin could have been Ring of Honor World Champion. He came as close as you can get, and there's still a good chance that somewhere down the road he's going to get another opportunity to become just that. So to score a victory over Elgin, man, that's huge for Logan Schuler.
Yeah. State may have chosen Adam Cole for the Ring of Honor World title now, but many say Elgin will be the next Ring of Honor World Champion, and when he wins that, if he wins that, people can look back at this matchup and see Logan Schuler as a potential future contender. And respect something Logan's big on. Elgin knows all about the code of honor.
Will he shake his hand, Joe?
Elgin's a proud fighter, but he knows when he's been bested. Great showing of respect. Shulo deserves nothing but respect. He won't get it from Shane Taylor, though. Winner take all, our next DVD release. Up next, Vic Chesney and Idol. Main event, Combat Clearfield.
Turn back to the episode bell, senior official officer Troy Davis.
When you're talking cumulative days, no one has held the IWC Championship longer throughout history than Big League John McChesney. Two important tests that certainly jeopardized that reign, as he can make for December 14th. He will take on the Party Peacock Dalton Castle, although under some shady circumstances, with Norm Connors as the guest referee. Tonight, McChesney will face, for my money, probably the most underrated wrestler to compete in Pittsburgh over the past decade and a half. He is Justin Idol, and I don't agree with his recent decisions in his career, but you can't deny what Idol has meant, Mr. Prasad, to this part of the country in independent wrestling.
That's the God's honest truth there, Joe. You know, there's a lot of things that Justin Idol has accomplished. We haven't seen much of him in the ring as of lately here in IWC, but tonight against fabulous John McChesney, I think we got ourselves a brawl.
The leader of Team Big League, or is he?
There's been quite the dissension in the ranks.
Who's minding the store? Who's calling the shots?
Too many chiefs in the kitchen, if you know what I mean.
Not surprisingly, the founding father, brother, and Dennis Gregory, Jimmy Vegas, by the side of Justin Idol, who has captured IWC tag team gold before, but has never had the big one. Idol felt disrespected by Chuck Roberts for a number of months, because Chuck made Idol run the ringer, beat so many individuals in a row to get his contract back. But Idol finally did tore up that contract in Chuck's face and decided to seek some salvation with the founding fathers, much to the chagrin of all of Idol's students at the ICWA training school.
You know, I don't always agree with things of that nature, but...
Hey! I didn't bring Team Big League out here. What's the deal?
You didn't bring Team Big League out here. Listen, Mr. Referee, sir, honorable judge and jury, myself and the monster Vegas, right, we're only here to sit here. We're just going to sit here so that Team Big League doesn't do what they always do.
Team
and help little Johnny hang on to his title. You better defend this title one-on-one, man-on-man, champ first challenger. Can you do it? I don't think so.
I'm sure that does not bode well with Fabulous and Team Big League.
Not at all. And you gotta believe that Shane Taylor is still in this building somewhere. We know, obviously, that Bobby Fish is still here. Joseph Brooks, who may have some wounded pride, he is still here as well, one would surmise. Of course, Jimmy Nutt's not here. Norm Connors, who knows?
Notorious Encon, he could always be working in the Raptors.
The executive consultant of Team Big League, who has taken big umbrage with Justin Labar, which really got me curious as to why Justin Labar was out here representing Shane Taylor earlier tonight.
It does pose a lot of questions, though. You know, one thing I do notice about the Founding Fathers, I appreciate their recent turn of heart.
You want me to remove him because you don't like him. So let's institute a new rule. Whoever these fans don't like, we're going to get rid of. Do you like John McChesney? So John, you can't have it both ways. What do you think? What do you think? Yes or no? Get rid of John McChesney. Justin,
that rhymed quite a bit. And I'm very proud to be joined once again by Dalton Castle, because Dalton, the biggest matchup of your career, I feel like I say that every month, but really the stakes keep raising.
If it doesn't get bigger each time, then why go forward?
The biggest match of your career is December 14th. It is winner take all. You and McChesney for the title, with the caveat of a special referee. And I'll be honest with you, that worries me quite a bit.
Worries you? I'm the one in the ring with that turd.
Norm Connors claims there will be no outside involvement. He claims that everything that's happened to you, to anybody else, to oppose Team Big League, has not been on his watch.
Look at these boys. John, all right. I have speaking ill of John for quite some time. I have called him garbage. I have said he's a disgrace to pro wrestling. But I will compliment the fact that he looks like he's taking himself serious and trying to get in a little bit of shape, which tells me he might be a little worried.
I think he'd have to be.
Well, he better be.
If the rumors of the McChesney-Norm Connors rift are true, there may be far bigger issues than even you and I know of. But the thing is, Dalton, you weren't here when Norm was running the show. I was. The side was, we know better than to trust Norm at face value.
Now, the mastermind Norm Connors, you gotta believe that, you gotta check the track record that has come across these things. You know, special guest referees, there's been many occasions. I mean, I can think of off the top of my head, just the case of Jimmy DeMarco. There's been many a times, there's been many a screw jobs. You never know what he has up his sleeve, because he's got all the answers.
Norm aside, John McChesney using some wrestling skills out there with the headlock takeover, maybe holding Mr. Idol down to his back again. I'm not worried about Norm. Norm McDonald? Norm McDonald or Norm Connors?
Norm Connors. Norm McDonald's somebody else. Sounds safe on.
I'm not worried about him preventing me from getting, or from causing me to get beat. I'm just worried about him following through with all three counts.
Right.
If he doesn't slap that mat three times, I don't win. He's not going to affect me in that ring whatsoever, because I'm the better wrestler, I'm the better athlete, I'm the better person.
You are the better person.
I would agree with that wholeheartedly, although the whole dynamic could change if Justin Idol wins the IWC title tonight, and let's not count that fact out. That very well could be a very real situation. Idol is very underrated for the past 15 years, former tag team champion, and there you see some of that lightning fast speed that at one point led to Idol being called the Aerial Icon.
Pardon the pun, but the ICWA.
Aerial Icon?
Yes.
Should we be talking like that?
Excuse me?
Aerial.
Oh! I thought you said something completely different.
To live in your mind for a day, young Dalton.
You wish.
The trainer of the ICWA Academy is literally taking McChesney to school right now.
Indeed he is, and McChesney having issues with Dennis Gregory. Gregory can be an easy distraction. Dalton, you were able to come out on top with Dennis Gregory, but keep in mind, you had Jimmy Corderas in there with you. 22 years experience in WWE. Norm Connors and Jimmy Corderas, polar opposites.
Straight shooter out there, right? Jimmy Corderas, he was willing to call it down the middle. He wanted that match. He didn't care who won. He just wanted to be fair.
He has integrity.
Norm has an agenda. I don't care what he says. He has an agenda to protect his baby boy out there with his back fat and his stupid hair.
Little boy body?
His little boy body.
which she's slowly turning into a man. It's cute. It's like watching a butterfly hatch.
Yeah, he's coming out of his cocoon. He must be doing CrossFit or something like that.
Yeah, but he looks less Wilford Brimley when he comes out of his cocoon.
You can make fun of the appearance of John McChesney. He brings a lot of it upon himself, but you can't deny the fact. You
can't deny the win-loss record between us.
Caginess, resourcefulness. Intelligence always has a plan, always a step or two ahead.
Well, I've said it before. Let's see where this is going here.
Chesney loves dropkick.
Oh, he's so dumb, 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 dumb.
Idle a step ahead.
Ouch.
Oklahoma roll for two. McChesney connects.
I have felt those before.
To your point, Dalton, you can't deny what McChesney's done in the ring. Let's catch this. Huge elevation on the baseball slide, thus proving further how dangerous McChesney can be.
To reiterate what I was going to say, I have said this before. I've promised to take home that title plenty of times. No longer promising that, because I don't follow through. I'm out to hurt Tom McChesney. If he somehow weasels a win and walks home with that title, he won't be coming back, because he will be limping home, and later, whatever internal bleeding's going on will cause some complications. I'm going to beat John McChesney, whether Norm counts to three or not.
Sounds like the party is over and the peacock is serious.
The party is over, buddy. It's power peacock time.
Power.
And that may have been what's been needed this whole time. Castle, he'll never think like you and I do. He always loves to have fun. He loves to entertain these people. But you can tell beneath that thin layer of comedy is a very focused competitor. As McChesney gets two in the ring, a man that's very focused and very determined, and a man, Dalton Castle, correct me if I'm wrong, I think part of you probably feels like you've let your fans down because you haven't been able to unseat McChesney.
Oh, big part of me. Yeah. When you make promises like that, you better deliver, and regardless of what I thought about other people stepping in and preventing it, it's just my focus. All right, I lost it, and I've got it back.
McChesney trying to drive that foot, idle a counter. Keep in mind, idle out. Given
this
match.
Shot. That's not how a wrestler should behave. All right, somebody holding the title that represents this company should be a little bit classy.
You know better than anyone that McChesney will do what he has to do by any means necessary to keep that title around his waist and to keep Team Big League on top.
He's a savage.
Idle was granted this championship matchup thanks to the bartering of Dennis Gregory, who said, hey, you want me to go out there and wrestle Dalton Castle? Do your business for you? Well, I'll do that, but Founding Fathers need some title shots.
Yeah, so a lot of pressure on Justin Idle's shoulders there to make up for what Dennis did for him. Remember when Dennis got dropped on his head three times? I did it. So if he doesn't follow through here, how is that going to make him look in front of his friends?
Oh, I love the barter system.
Near fall, Idle kicks out. McChesney, again, we talked about a little bit earlier tonight of opponents looking past tonight towards winner take all. If McChesney does it, he could be in for some problems.
He's smart, though, what he's doing there. All right, I don't think John's got the gas to go the distance, and he's choking all the air out of Justin Idle there.
You know, at this point, it's even though we haven't seen much of Idle in the ring as of recently, I can remember maybe about a year and a half ago, myself and Justin Idle in this very building also going the distance, a 20-minute time limit. And, you know, I think that he has the endurance to best John McChesney if it turns out to be a blow-for-blow type of match like we have right now.
They're punching each other right as we speak.
Square in the face.
Looks like a blow-for-blow match.
Well, we know Idle.
Where did he get that?
We know Idle has great conditioning. From his time at the school, Idle loves those knee strikes.
Oh, vicious elbow.
That one not so much.
Is Justin out? Does he know where he is? Yeah, he does. He's got control. That looked like muscle memory.
Dragon suplex release style. McChesney folded on top of himself.
Justin Idle busting out some new moves in the repertoire.
And this is the opening Justin Idle needed. Who would have ever thought a crowd cheering on the Founding Fathers, but they hate McChesney that much.
Dennis Gregory is losing his mind at ringside. He's taking his shirt off, waving around his head like a helicopter.
This could be the opening Idle needs. Dragon one more time, countered. Chesney feeling the adverse effects of this matchup.
Baby cutter.
Yeah.
Then a kick to the face.
All impact on that one. Great follow through. Deep hook and almost at him. And Dalton almost had an entirely new landscape for winner take all.
Chesney needs to check his mouth, make sure all his teeth are still there, because that was a straight kick to the mouth.
I'm sorry, were you talking to me? I'm focused.
Yeah, I was about to remark, you can't see it at home, but Dalton Castle not blinking. Just focused, zoned in on this ring right now.
Going for the spirit crusher.
Indeed. Side of Dalton I haven't seen before, and that may be what's needed to get this job done. It may be what's needed to finally culminate this journey.
Fabulous, go for the TKO.
But Chesney gotta get through Idol first. We gotta roll up. Look at this. On the 16th anniversary of the Montreal Screwjob, McChesney sits in the sharpshooter.
A sharpshooter. Was it a screwjob, though, Joe? Was it? I don't.
Well, you got 5.5 hours. I'll talk to you after the show, but right now, the IWC title is what's the story. And Idol gets to the ropes.
That's smart. That's good ring awareness right there. I don't care how much you get dropped on your head. If you know where you are in that ring, you have an advantage.
Veteran instincts.
Screaming, he beats him at the top of his lungs.
McChesney's never gotten along with Clearfield. I remember 1 year Necro Butcher beat the hell out of him. McChesney's most embarrassing moments, most of them, have taken place in this building. McChesney determined not to add one to that list.
Both men battling on top.
I don't think either guy wants to be up there.
Not at all.
Idol's perfected his ground game in recent years.
Blocks a super kick, dragging almost into the buckle. Jeez, that's dangerous.
My God, McChesney, the whiplash effect. And I believe McChesney's head at least grazed that buckle, which is enough to trip that neck on the landing.
Goes for the spear crusher again.
He hits this, it's over. Joseph Brooks!
What the heck?
We got that confetti cannon again.
Bad blaster all over the place.
Why did Justin Idol just stop?
Idol distracted. The Founding Fathers running off Brooks.
This is a mistake. This is a big mistake. Idol needs to get his focus.
And Vegas,
turn around,
and Brooks face to face. Oh my God! The referee got wiped out.
Referee Troy Davis had his back broken against the guardrail.
And Dalton, these are the kind of distractions that may face you in a month.
I'm not gonna end up like a referee.
Troy Davis is hurt.
Broke the guardrail.
Oh my God, this is a. And Vegas is gonna do the same to Brooks. Man, we got problems out here. And McChesney from behind in the ring. This match is still ongoing. And we have no referee.
Fabulous making his own count, but all for naught.
Yeah, it doesn't count. We need another official. The title's on the line here. The stakes are too high.
Joe, did he super kick him in the back of the head?
Oh, my God.
Oh, Shane Taylor.
375.
Here comes trouble.
He injured Shulo. He injured Justin Plummer.
Look at the look in Shane Taylor's eyes.
Oh, it's the window to the soul. No way home. Taylor hit McChesney. And Big League's best laid plans have backfired. But Idol still gotta fight for his life. Low bridge.
Taylor spills out to the floor. And Fabulous is up.
McChesney waiting again.
Idol needs to turn around. Oh, catches a super kick. Needed.
This is the BS.
Spear crusher.
Done.
Oh, this MJ Club is out of nowhere.
Referee. Got him.
Referee Jack Clemens. Makes the three count.
I don't agree with that finish.
We have a new champion.
Party Peacock, what is your thoughts on this? This is
Party's
insane.
I told you it could happen. I told you don't count Idol out. And Idol has accomplished his 15-year dream in Clearfield, Pennsylvania.
I cannot believe my eyes right now. Troy Davis is crawling out of the curtain. What's going on? What's going on? No.
Davis needs medical help. He's got to get out of here. Idol's the new champion. Team Big League's been thwarted. The dynamic has changed moving forward. Dalton Castle very distressed. What does this mean for winner take all?
What in the? It's the
listen into what Troy Davis has to say.
What is this?
Ladies and gentlemen, I have just been informed by IWC senior official Mr. Troy Davis that due to the actions of Dennis Gregory and Jimmy Vegas throwing him through the guardrail, he has disqualified Justin Idol. Oh. Therefore, still your IWC heavyweight champion as a result of this disqualification.
Can you believe this, Joe? The founding fathers getting their attitudes get the better of them, costing Idol the match that he had won. He had that title in his hands.
How close can you get? And the men that Idol aligned with to stick it to the system comes back to haunt him.
I can't believe it.
McChesney escapes again.
One more time, Big League.
Whether he realized it or not.
They just, they find the way to weasel their way out of everything.
You know, I wish I could say I was surprised, but Team Big League, that's just what they're known for. Shenanigans. Well, let's see you get out of this one. The Founding Fathers, Team Big League, impromptu match right now.
What? The people want it.
I want it. Let's see this. This score needs to be settled once and for all.
Yeah, I'm down. Let's do this.
Vegas is doing push-ups in the ring.
The Founding Fathers are energized here. Oh, imagine Shane Taylor and Jimmy Vegas hooking up.
Talk about the immovable object.
And the bell is rung, and McChesney just turned around and he just left his boy to the wolves. He left his boy to the wolves. There's Dalton Castle.
Dalton Castle.
On the entrance way. Dalton's got McChesney and Dalton Castle throws Big League back into the fire. Don't knock and let McChesney sneak out. This is about 5 weeks before their title match.
All three men on top right now.
And time for Team Baby to pay some dues. And what's going to happen when Norm Connors gets wind of this?
Founding Fathers making fools of Team Big League right here. Wasn't quite the match we were expecting, but the Founding Fathers were standing tall right here in the ring tonight, Joe.
And John McChesney retains the IWC Championship, most important story there. He moves on to 5 weeks from tonight, December the 14th, winner take all 13, our next DVD release. John McChesney, Dalton Castle for the IWC title with Norm Connors, the special guest referee. I don't know how it's possible, but it's Dalton's one chance. Ladies and gentlemen, that plus Logan Chulo and Shane Taylor. Seema Ion finally gets his hands on RJ City. And so much more. It's one of the biggest events of the year. It's winner take all for Prasad, Aiden, Fish, Dalton, Seema, and everybody else. We'll see you then on IWC Home Video.